random expenses pop up, like a major car repair, a cell phone replacement, a speeding ticket, or an urgent medical treatment, and even worse, in a short time frame, like a month time frame, well, I have. And a few years ago, if I experienced those random expenses pop up in my life, I would have ignored it. I would have ignored it until it got bad, to the point that I couldn't ignore it anymore and I had to face reality. And it would have stressed me out so much. But now I have a strategy that I use that helps me to deal with random unexpected expenses, so I'm able to keep my cool and avoid money-related stressors. I'm Shana of The Wealth Vibe, and I create videos to help you eliminate debt, grow your income, and build wealth. Recently, I lost my iPhone just to find out that a few days later, I had a $600 car repair. And mind you, I was making less than $1,000 a month at that time. But surprisingly, those unexpected random expenses didn't stress me out because I had sinking funds in place. Otherwise, those expenses would have busted my budget and probably bankrupted me. So I'm going to share with you my strategy for making sure that I have no stress when unexpected expenses pop up. Before I get into the video, if you have ever experienced unexpected expenses before and you no longer want to feel stressed out about those expenses whenever they do pop up, because they will pop up, go ahead and give this video a like, because I'm going to share with you my strategy so you don't have to feel overwhelmed anymore when things randomly pop up in your budget. Sinking funds are a strategy that I use to help me cover expenses that are either goals, irregular, or unexpected. And basically, a sinking fund is a pot of money, a small pot of money, that is earmarked for expenses that are either goals, irregular, or unexpected. And you can depend on these funds in those times, and you know that you have a pot of money available so that you don't have to touch your emergency fund. So you might be a little confused right now, and you might have been thinking like, wait, whenever I have a major car repair come up, or if I were to lose my cell phone, or if any random expense were to come up, I would go to my emergency fund. Well, you typically don't want to do that, because your emergency fund should be used for really major expenses and things that are kind of like life-changing. So in my mind, emergency funds are to help you through a job loss or to cover expenses from a major catastrophic health event. So if you were to have a serious health event that costs thousands and thousands of dollars, you would be able to rely on your emergency fund in those cases. But sinking funds are really smaller pots of money that range from like a few dollars up to a couple thousand dollars. Whereas your emergency fund is going to be like maybe tens or even $20,000, depending on your own lifestyle. So sinking funds are smaller and available for you if you need to cover any type of goal, irregular, or unexpected expenses that might come up in your life. And they are a lifesaver, and they help you with achieving your wealth goals, such as building up your net worth, because you don't have to tap into your emergency fund whenever some random expense pops up. Here's the deal. We like to think that some of these expenses are random, unknown, and unexpected. But truth be told, many of these expenses are known and expected. But the issue is that we fail to plan for these expenses. And with sinking funds in place, you can plan effectively for these expenses whenever they do occur. And like I like to say, that if you fail to plan, then you plan to fail. So here's what I think you should do. If you are going to set up sinking funds, I think there are three types of sinking funds that you should have, so that you can have an airtight budget, and it will reduce your money-related stress whenever these expenses do occur. Because we are living a life when expenses are actually going to occur. So we want to make sure that we're setting ourselves up for success. You'll want to have sinking funds for things that are known but irregular expenses. So some of those things might be your car insurance or medical expenses or health expenses like dental care or replacing your eyeglasses or some home repair issues that you might have to do on an annual or semi-annual basis. So those are things that you know are gonna happen, but they tend to happen irregularly, so you tend to forget about them. But if you have sinking funds in place, you won't have to worry about forgetting about them, and it won't be such a shock when you finally do remember them because you have this pot of money set aside for those expenses. Then you'll wanna have sinking funds to cover expenses that are unknown. So these are expenses that just happen because stuff happens, right? And they are things that are bound to happen eventually in life, but they happen so rarely that you can't really count on them happening to you. So unknown expenses in my mind are things like fines, tickets, violations, and sometimes even taxes, because you might be thinking that you're paying up your taxes only to find out that the federal government is knocking down at your door saying you owe them money. And that happens sometimes. And those are some things that you just don't know about. You genuinely don't know that they're going to happen. But you want to have a pot of money set aside for them in sinking funds, just in case they ever do happen, so that they don't stress you out. And in my mind, you won't really know what those unknown expenses are because they're unknown, right? But you wanna have some money there, like a buffer there to help you out. And typically having anywhere from $100 to $500 will typically cover a lot of those fines and tickets and violations that might tend to occur, and you should be good with just having a little bit of that money set aside for you. The last type of sinking fund that you'll wanna have is for your goals. We all have goals in life, especially if you're an ambitious person like I am. You have a lot of goals. So in order to achieve your goals, many of times, it costs money, right? And so some of your goals might be vacation or to save up to buy a home, so you'll need a down payment. So things like that are goals that you'll wanna have in sinking funds. So you'll want to have money set aside for your goals that you wanna achieve that you know are gonna cost you money, and most goals do cost you money. So that's another type of sinking fund that you'll wanna have. Now, if you wanna get started with sinking funds, there are two ways that you can go about it. You can go about it the cash way or the digital way. So if you do the cash route, typically what people do is they put their money for sinking funds in cash envelopes. So they'll put money in an envelope and then label that envelope with whatever the expenses or whatever the goal is, so that way they are able to access money in that envelope or save money in that envelope for whenever that expense does come up, and they're able to reach for it and then take the money out of there and then spend the money on whatever that expense is. So that's the cash route. And if you want more information on cash envelopes, I have a video here that you can check out. It goes into much more detail about how to do cash envelopes. But you also have the digital way, and we're living in a modern world, and if you're like me, you like the digital way, because the digital way requires you to have no cash. Everything just happens in your bank accounts behind the scenes and most likely automatic. And if you know anything about me, you know that I love some automation. So I love the digital way of setting up sinking funds. So there are a few different ways that you can have digital sinking funds. If you're going the digital route, there are three different solutions that you can use to set up your digital sinking funds. So you can either use Capital, Chime, or Simple. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about each one of them because they work well for different people and they have great features overall, but you want to pick the one that works best for how you like to manage your money. So with Capital, Capital is a micro savings app that is separate from your bank account. Capital actually is not a bank in of itself, but what they do is that they allow you to set up your digital envelopes for your sinking funds. And you're able to, with each transaction that you make with your bank account, you're able to round up those transactions to the next dollar, and those roundups will go towards your sinking funds. So it's a great way to save for your sinking funds in a really passive way, and you don't really have to think about it on a day-to-day basis. So it's a great option for people who really don't want to do a lot of hands-on management, and they're just trying to put away some extra money just by doing the regular things that they do in life. So as I said, capital is not a bank, and it's really good for people who want to separate their sinking funds from their personal banking. And the great thing about capital is that they actually have a referral program. So if you send someone your link to sign up for Capital, you'll actually get some rewards for actually referring your friends. And if you're interested in checking out Capital, I'll have my link down in the description box so that we can both make a little bit of money on our referrals. So it's a really great way if you are looking for a separate solution to be able to do some micro savings passively. The next solution is very similar to Capital, but they have two different features that make them a little bit better, and it might work better for you if you're looking for a bank. So Chime is a bank, and they have the auto micro savings feature that Capital does. So you're able to set up your sinking funds in a similar way, and then every time you make a purchase, your transactions are rounded up to the next dollar, and your roundups are sent into your sinking funds. So you're able to save passively for your goals. But in this case, Chime is a bank in of itself. So if you're looking for banking features together with your sinking funds, this is a really good option for you. And a bonus thing that Chime has to offer is that they actually deliver your paychecks sooner than you would with traditional banks. So they deliver your paychecks a few days earlier. So they help you get started with your finances a few days earlier so that you never have to worry about going, you know, extra days without money to use. And so it's a really good solution if you want to not only have a bank, but also get your paychecks a little bit earlier than you would have. So if you're interested in signing up for Chime, they also do have a referral program. And so if you want to check it out, you can use my link down in the description box to sign up for Chime, because it's a great way to set up your sinking funds. The next solution is the solution that I actually use for my sinking funds, and I've been using Simple for a long time because they have been around for much longer than Capital and Chime have been, and I just started using them and I like them, and so that's what I use for my own sinking funds. Now with Simple, they are actually a bank. So similar to Chime, your money with Simple is FDIC insured because they are actually a bank. But the difference with Simple and the first two solutions that I said is that Simple doesn't actually offer the micro automatic savings roundup feature. Now with Simple, what their goal is really to have a wealth management or a money management tool. So their whole objective is to get you budgeting. And so they're a bank that is really focused on making sure that you really stick to your budget. So they have two different features that you can use within Simple Bank that allow you to do your sinking funds. So they have the goals and the expenses feature. And depending on how often you're using the money for your sinking funds, you might want to choose one feature over the other, but I tend to use both. It just depends. So if I am saving up for a vacation, I'll save up my money and my sinking funds through the goals feature. But if I'm having expense for clothing that I might want to spend money more frequently from that sinking fund, I'll use the expense feature. But it's a really good tool that will allow you to digitize your sinking funds in a bank. Now, unfortunately, Simple Bank suspended their referral system, so I don't have a way that you can earn any type of bonuses or anything with Simple Bank, but it is definitely a really good solution if you're not only looking for a bank, but if you're looking for an all-in-one type of solution that's not only going to get you sinking funds, but also get you budgeting, you'll want to check out Simple Bank. And I'll have a link down in the description box just so that it makes it a little easier for you to sign up for it, but you're not going to get any bonuses or anything for signing up using my link down below. Sinking funds are a tool that you definitely want to have to help you manage your personal finances, because they're a pile of money that will dwindle over time to help you cover expenses that pop up. That way you're not busting your budget and you're not dabbling or dipping into your emergency fund. So I talked a little bit about emergency funds in this video, and you might be wondering, what are emergency funds and how can you get one set up? So you want to check out this video right here, and it'll tell you a little bit more about emergency funds, because they're a great way to save you in major emergencies and they're a great wealth management tool for you as well. So you want to check out this video here, and I hope that you are subscribed and you hit the notification bell so you can be notified when I release more videos. But I'm planning to catch you in the next video here, so thanks for watching.